We will not talk about RAID 3 because it's very, very rarely used today. So we will go to RAID 4, which is actually not very often used, but it helps understand how it works to understand how RAID 5, which is more often used, works. RAID 4 uses a technique called block interleaved parity. It uses n disks. N-1, all but one, of these disks contain data which is striped across these disks just like in RAID 0. And then the last disk has the parity blocks that protect all of the blocks of the N-1 disks. So let's look at an example with four disks. So we said that three of the disks contain data. So this would be stripe 0. Then here we have stripe 3, 4, and 5, and so on. So we just distribute our data across all but one disk. And then we take the data of stripe 0, XOR the whole stripe bit by bit with stripe 1, XOR the whole thing with stripe 2, and what we get will be as long as a stripe, and that gives us the parity stripe for 0, 1, and 2, and we put that on the fourth disk. Then we go to the next stripe on each disk, XOR them, and that gives us the parity stripe for these three stripes, and so on. So the idea here is that if, let's say, one disk fails, we have the data of the two disks here, and we have the parity. We can reconstruct what was on the first disk by XORing these three. Or if there is an error in just, for example, this one stripe gets too damaged to reconstruct by using the error correction code of this disk, in that case, again, we can read this stripe, and the parity, and then reconstruct what should have been the bits of this. So effectively, now we can tolerate the failure of any one disk, but the cost is not two times as many disks as we need to store the data. Here, for example, we are paying only 1/4 of the whole system is spent on parity and 3/4 on the data. Whereas with mirroring, we would have spent half of the overall capacity of the system on the mirroring. You can think of RAID 4 as kind of a more general technique than mirroring, because in reality, using two disks for RAID 4 is very similar to mirroring, because here we will store the bits of the data, and here we will store the same bits, because a bit, when you don't XOR it with anything, you just put it here. So mirroring is just an extreme case of RAID 4 when n is just 2. But you want to go to more than 2 with RAID 4 because that allows you to have lower cost while still being able to recover from losing one disk. So now, what does a write do? It must write one of the data disks and it must read and write the parity disk to update the parity because one of the stripes have changed. A read, however, only needs to read the data from the disk where the data is. We will only reconstruct the data if that read fails. But in the normal scenario where we get the data we want, we don't even have to consult the parity bit for reads.